Well, there is some optimism here at World Pork Expo. After what was the worst financial year on record for most pork producers last year, the situation is looking more positive this year. Another area of optimism, how the pork industry is finding new ways to cater to pork demand, carving out new methods based on different generations. It's actually really interesting, as we show you in this week's Farm Journal report. No matter where you travel, pork producers across the U.S. just weathered a heavy storm.
Last 2 years was the toughest two-year stretch I've ever gone through in my life. The financial losses were terrible.
Al Wolfkohl raises pigs in northeast Iowa, and he says they've been in survival mode the past 2 years.
We've been through tough times before in my lifetime. I went through 1998 when we had a packer capacity shortage, and I went through other times too. But it's kind of survival, and then you look forward to better days.
Better days are exactly what Wolfkohl and other pork board members are working to create.
It really just emphasizes the importance of demand. I joined the board with a demand platform. Wise guy once told me, I don't care how cheap you can raise pork, if you can't sell it, it doesn't do you a bit of good. We've not asked our consumer about their habits. And so, you know, to learn was just really important for me, you know, as a leader and as a producer, to understand.
In order to better understand consumers, the National Pork Board launched a segmentation study to see who's eating or not eating pork and why.
The biggest challenge today around pork, it really is centered around one word, relevancy. And that's a hard pill to swallow for someone in the pork business like myself.
David Newman is a Missouri pork producer, but he's also senior vice president of market growth for the National Pork Board.
But the reality of the situation today is that the baby boomer generation has carried the bulk of this business for the last 20 or 30 years. And as we're starting to see a transition in shift to millennials and Gen Zs, the future consumers of pork, then we really need to focus on that.
Newman says instead of a shotgun approach in targeting all different types of consumers, the National Pork Board launched a segmentation study to see, one, who is pork's customer, and two, what matters to those different segments of customers.
And it's really a transformational moment for pork to put a focus on who the future consumer is. We can't be all things to all people. We can take a more targeted approach to a strategy.
The study showed seven different segments of consumers, ranging from confident meat eaters and culinary adventurers to tasty value seekers and simple feeders.
What this does is it gives you an opportunity to really, when you go into a marketing strategy, you can go to each one of those segmented populations and you can position pork in a way that is relevant to them.
Morgan Wunderly runs the University Swine Farm at Cal Poly San Luis Obispo, and she also teaches courses there.
Out at Cal Poly, about 80% of our students come from Los Angeles County and the Bay Area. And so getting to expose them to swine production, I think, is so important because some of them have never even seen a pig in their whole life.
She says she does a lot of myth busting in her class while also discovering why the college students aren't big consumers of pork.
I think one of the biggest concerns that they come back with is, you know, hearing it's not a healthy product, hearing that it's not raised properly, right? And so I think we're combating that at the National Pork Board level. So there are 8 lean cuts of pork. It's an awesome product. You know, we are making decisions every day on the farm that are impacting the pigs and the way we raise them in a healthy way.
Wunderly says she often asks her students how many have eaten pork at the center of the plate in the past week.
Last week I asked them this, and 2 of them raised their hand out of 72, right? And so they're using pork as an ingredient versus the traditional center of the plate. And so we're using that as a tool. Let's have recipes and let's have air fryer recipes and be more relevant with the younger generation versus saying, hey, have a pork chop and a potato and some vegetables and you're good to go.
Newman says that's another changing trend with younger generations in how they consume and cook pork.
For the first time ever, data that was just released from the National Pork Board says there are more air fryers in homes in America than there are coffee makers. So these consumers, they cook a tremendous number of their meals with items that baby boomers may not even own.
Newman says that means creating smaller cuts that can fit into an air fryer, but also including recipes that make it easy for those generations to cook are going to be key. And that does require making more relevant products, but it's also spurring innovation.
Every day someone calls me and asks me about pork nuggets, as an example. While it may be relevant and down the road, You have to build consumer confidence and relevance, and innovation will follow.
Newman says by working with packers and processors, food service companies, and even retailers, they're positioning pork products in a way that matters to consumers.
A rising tide will lift all boats, and that you'll actually start to see something that can be spread throughout the industry, therefore translates into not only volume and consumption, but sales.
It's a new frontier for pork, and one these producers are confident will grow demand.
I'm so proud of the Pork Board in the fact that we've doubled down around demand. We have got to be patient. It's not something that you wave your magic wand over and it's going to happen overnight. This is a decade to maybe a two-decade process that we all have to be behind.
I think it's how we're going to win and how we're ultimately going to, you know, meet the consumer where they're at and win and build an appetite for pork.
We're going to win over consumer demand. We're going to show the younger generation how to better prepare pork and how to cook pork, how to eat pork, how it fits into their diet and the nutritional value and the value. I mean, it's a lower priced meat protein and it's one of the most nutrient dense proteins that you can consume.
It's a transformational moment for the pork business. Yes, we have a very unique opportunity today on the backside of a very dark time over the last 2 years. We have an opportunity here to transformationally think different.
All right, when we come back, a glimpse around the globe. That's next.